on Wednesday?
Next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday.
Yes.
27.
27, that's fine.
Then why don't you tell us where you stand with them?
With CONCOM?
Sure.
Okay, yeah. For the record, I'm Philip Christensen, engineer for the applicant. You know, with CONCOM, the last meeting was really just to establish the wetlands line. And that was confirmed, but it was, because we were making changes with engineering, we hadn't yet given them the final set. So we did meet with engineering and with conservation department. We made changes in the engineering parts of the plan, which I guess you've seen, where we've, instead of having a 24-foot wide road, we've widened it to 26 feet. We've got granite curbs both sides. But on one side of the project, partly based on the email that Julie sent with some ideas I think you sent on curb openings. We have curb openings on one side of the, on this side of the roadway that allows the water to go into swales and infiltration areas. So we have, there's some minor changes engineering wants in terms of some notes on the plan and other things. But we're basically, the design you have is the one that engineering's approved. What we have here is this proposal for conservation. And this lot 3, relatively large lot. And what the applicants have suggested is this piece of land here will be given to conservation. This is 110 feet deep from this lot line. And this dimension 74 feet from here to here. So this entire piece will be donated to conservation. And then there'll be a walking easement here along the lot line alone. And this provides, as best we can, access to the conservation lands, which is something that conservation is looking for. Any questions you have with respect to the rest of the subdivision? Be happy to answer them for you.
I might just add one note really quick. So I don't know if you saw my email, but typically with the easements for trails, conservation likes to have 10 feet. I don't know if that's something you would entertain. It's really nice that we're getting the 5 feet.
I thought the trail system was 5 feet.
The trail is 5 feet, but they like to have the 10-foot wide easement. So just something to think about.
I like 7 and a half.
Drainage.
You can work that out with conservation, but I just wanted to let you know. That's something Chuck mentioned to me, that he was surprised to see that.
Surprised it was 5?
Yeah.
What?
I don't know if he didn't communicate exactly what he wanted or.
Will.
That's fine.
If they're only willing to give 5.
You worked that out with conservation.
Yeah.
I'm okay with 5, but maybe they needed to run some sort of piece of.
A little room to work, 7 and a half.
The, I thought in one of the notes, there was a proposal for the easement in waiting, if you will, something that would be activated only if the access to the so forth was approved.
This kind of solves that problem. Now the town will own the land. If they get future access, then it'll be to town-owned land. And that was one of the problems. They wanted access to multiple points. We didn't want a bunch of easement lines running across private property.
Yeah.
And this kind of solves a couple of those problems for everybody.
Okay, so this is the answer to that situation. Okay.
And I think also having the easement established when the property is opened, and the owners have a sort of expectation of what this means. It's not something they're surprised by 10 years down when something else happens, so.
I think if plant bushes now, they'll grow up to be a little, you know, barrier.
Landscape, but if you had to create a privacy barrier, that was something. I don't have any other issues because engineering was all set. And conservation sounds like they're going to be all set. Comments, John?
No.
Comments from the public? Not here for this? No? We did receive some letters, you know, regarding traffic on the roadway. But I think that the board was in agreement that we didn't think that this particular development was going to cause, I don't know, the traffic really comes from.
Yeah, I mean, certainly the I'll take their word for it. There is an issue of traffic along this road. It seems, from my observation, that seems like that is likely the case, and the alignment of the road is definitely not optimal. But this is not this isn't going to generate the traffic that you're even gonna notice the difference.
I mean, there's a chance it will improve the situation just by changing that stretch of the road, changing the appearance and so on and so forth. I mean, it's from a road network point of view, it's a bad point for the whole town.
Yeah, and I didn't want the residents in the area to think that we were ignoring them. But even when you think about how that roadway works and when you look at the crash reports, they're all Zero Main and Franklin, right? Zero Main and Franklin, Zero Haverhill and Franklin. So to me, those are the intersections at the two ends where people are probably getting each other as they're stopping. It's not happening at every single driveway down the road. And I use that road all the time on a motorcycle, so I'm more than aware of what's going on as I'm going down and paying attention. I never felt threatened.
So there was a suggestion that I made on page 4 of the decision, number 13, that this subdivision regulations do allow you to ask for site easements at the roadway apron if you feel so inclined.
I think the town has a bylaw that says you're not allowed to plant anything on a corner, right? Because as I was coming here,
there was a bylaw that went to town meeting about that, but it did not get.
Okay. You can't take your right on red at Summer and Hoover. That house has shrubs.
Yeah, there's a couple of those
that block the sightline way up.
I guess. My thought on this, that in this particular configuration, I'm not sure that does much for you.
I don't think it's necessary in this particular case.
Okay.
It's directly across, or almost directly across from the cemetery entrance, and just putting in the cul-de-sac will open that up on the development side.
Yeah, it's wider than driveways, and that side of the road is already, there's no shoulder. Sometimes the poles seem to be right at the edge of pavement. Sometimes other properties have their landscaping or fences or other stuff right up against that line. So this should open up just from the width.
Yeah.
It's being twice what one of the other driveways.
So I can remove that from the decision. You don't think that's...
What do you think? I mean, we could ask him not to plant anything within 5 feet of the back line. There's a handicap ramp on the one side, so that'll at least be clear.
Yeah, I thought there was also a condition about wrapping the sidewalk around that John had mentioned at the last meeting.
I thought John said bring it around and bring it across somewhere, but then we couldn't figure out... Bring it around and then across.
Have it come to like the end here so that...
There's no crosswalks on this road.
No, I mean there could be one added, but that'll be up to the Board of Selectmen.
Mm-hmm. When?
Well, so if we want to go forward with a crosswalk here, we have the Parking Traffic Transportation Task Force that will discuss it and then make a recommendation to the Board of Selectmen. So if it's something that you really want as part of this project, We actually have a PTTF meeting on Wednesday, so I can bring it up then.
Can we leave it that it's the way it's shown, unless you're a better idea, and that if that committee wants it slid over around the curb, you can modify? Because, I mean, you won't be putting that until...
That'd be at the end anyways.
Okay, sure.
Yeah, I thought we had talked about wrapping that, sidewalk instead of it coming like it's shown there, just parallel with the street around the corner, and then with the potential to have a crosswalk that's, I'm going to say, even between the beginning of the radius of this road and the radius of the entrance into the cemetery. To me, that seems like, because you want to minimize that crossing distance as much as possible, probably especially on this road if
coming around the turn from the west, so.
And that, like you said, if that is open, all right, if that's a crosswalk, if that's a sidewalk that wraps around the edge of the corner, then obviously no one's going to be planting anything there.
That's true.
It's up that sideline.
Yeah. So that's what we would recommend, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wrap it.
Yep.
Bring it across.
Okay. Yeah, and the crosswalk will leave to
the
traffic committee.
Well, bring it to the attention of the traffic committee.
Yeah, I can bring it to their attention on Wednesday.
Good.
Okay, so we're going to delete 13, but are we going to add anything in here about this crosswalk?
The crosswalk's already in there. I said it should be removed because it needs to be approved first.
I see it.
Where did I put that?
It's on page 6.
Oh, yeah.
Remove from the plan and leave it as a written.
But we could be more specific. Oh, so actually in 4, right above where it's crosswalk, I mentioned the sidewalk wrapping. So I could be more specific about how the sidewalk and crosswalk might work, maybe not. Maybe I'll leave it.
I think number 4 is 6 states it reasonably.
Okay. And then the crosswalk we'll just leave up to the PTTF and the Board of Selectmen.
Sure.
Okay.
And they'll see where their sidewalk goes.
Yeah. Should we remove it from the plan, though?
I think so, yeah. Especially because it's probably not going to end up right there if you wrap the sidewalk.
Yeah.
Which
makes sense. Right. Confusion.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other comments?
No.
So, should we close the public hearing?
Move that the CPDC close the public hearing for the definitive subdivision plan 4854 Franklin Street, known as the Barton Estates.
Second.
All in favor?
Okay. Anything?
Did you see the decision? Do you have any questions, comments, objections, edits?
You can see it.
So the section 13, whatever it is, in the findings is
these plans are listed in the materials.
I'll have to list the new plans that I got today.
Okay.
Trees. You're putting every green tree.
Yeah, with the green around it, yeah. So there's street trees and then there's trees because of the square footage of the lot, and then trees for conservation, so.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a lot of them.
Do we actually have species for all of those?
We do not.
Do you work with the tree warden, or?
Tree warden, certainly for the street trees.
Okay.
The developer for, in the lots themselves, and with conservation. But what's out there now is maple, cherry, and pine. Pretty much, and oak.
DPW,
kind of a mix, really.
DPW has a list of trees that probably like the street trees.
Sure.
You can do
probably,
it.
Probably goes without saying, but the one that you show in the place where you're going to wrap around the sidewalk probably ends up getting rid of that probably is the best.
Yeah.
As you move somewhere.
Yeah. Or relocating that, so.
The conservation allows, I think, two bushes instead of a tree out of there, so we made supplements to those.
Yeah.
So, page 3, number 8, where it says no tree plan has been submitted.
Yeah, I'll revise that.
Okay.
Let's see what direction Julie would be. When we changed the grading plan, we were able to connect the last two homes to the gravity sewer.
Oh, okay.
So, on number 10, we won't need the pumps.
Okay.
And,
all right. So, I just take that sentence out. Amend the list of waivers because some of them changed, but I did get a revised list from the applicant, so I'll add those.
Okay.
As well.
Do we have to vote on each of these?
You probably should just take a vote in general. I mean, you can do them specifically if you want, but.
Any objections to any particular one? Number one is the topography plan. Then I'm going to feel like this. Two is showing wetlands within 200 feet. Requests to show wetlands in the locus only. Number 3 is the full traffic report versus the site distance and trip generation. Number 4 is the pavement width down to 26 from 30. Number 5 is sidewalk on one side. Number 6 is the cross section requirement, 10 foot wide strip between sidewalk and the roadway. But a 4-foot wide strip. Number 7 requires the roadway to be contiguous from the right-of-way layout. That's the waiver to build a roadway off-center to allow the storm management system.
Right, so the pavement's shifted within the layout.
That's something we should fix when we get around to fixing all, right? To allow that.
So they don't have to have a waiver.
So they don't have to have a waiver for it, because we would almost always grant it if it makes it better design.
It makes sense in this application, definitely. Yeah.
And number 8 is street cross section requires island in the cul-de-sac. And they're going to pave it. Even though, I think that was the, was that engineering or DPW's?
Fire.
It was fire. Fire didn't really want that.
Yeah.
That's something we'll have to think about as well, how we, what we paved that with. Maybe we can use something permeable in the future.
Do you still have a 50-foot radius?
Yes.
Because you only have to have a 45-foot
radius.
No, it's
45 on the pavement. Yes, you're
right. All right. I was just trying to reduce
pavement. No, it's 45,
possible.
Yeah.
Okay.
And with fire and DPW, we're real concerned on how to plow it.
One of the problems with anything other than the asphalt in the circle, then, is the plowing. They just like plow straight through. So if we would have put cobblestones or something.
No, I'm thinking more like a pervious concrete. more solid, you know, something that they can't chop up as easily. And it doesn't really require
maintenance awesome.
Other than vacuuming it every year or so, whatever. So, do we want to vote on the waivers? Does anyone have a problem with the waivers? Just accept them as they are?
No.
Yeah.
Okay.
How do we do this?
Just do a general motion.
Yeah, general motion as amended and to accept all the waivers, I would say. We've got some edits.
Okay. Move that the CPDC approve the definitive subdivision plan for 4854 Franklin Street. And the including the requested waivers.
Eight waivers.
Including the eight waivers, yes, from the memo dated
September 20th.
And the decision as amended.
Second.
All in favor?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Send a revised version of this to you, a finalized version to you tomorrow.
Julie, thanks for your efforts.
Sure.
Appreciate it.
Do we have to wait till 8 o'clock to continue the next piece? Anyone here for the Meadowbrook?
It might be good because I did tell the neighborhood, but like just in case someone trickles in.
Yeah. Wait.
You know. But you can do minutes in the meantime. You don't have to have a lull this time.
Okay. All right. Let's look at the minutes for
8:14 and 8:28. 9:11 are still in process. They're behemoth minutes lately. So.
I reviewed the 8:14 minutes and found nothing.
Page one.
Okay.
It says, third paragraph down, Mr. Doyle, the contractor, stated that the occupancy permit has been issued.
Yeah, right.
And then a question at the bottom sentence of that same paragraph says, the transoms and bottoms of the windows will remain clear. And above that it says the lower section of the windows.
Oh, yeah, take out bottoms.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm like cross-eyed from looking at minutes.
Sure. Do you ever go to the tape or the video?
Well, so she does. She types them now and then she redoes them from the tape sometimes. And then I just like clean them up. So I don't personally. For self-preservation purposes.
That's fine. Because I can't write the names down fast enough to. I usually get the first name, but sometimes I don't get the second name before they start talking. If public makes comments,
I always have to look up their names. So.
Yeah, we do. We cross-check with the sign-in sheet and with like the
book
assessor's information and stuff to make sure we get the names right.
Okay. Great.
Nothing else.
States they are not in favor of this type of development. Can we change that to design?
Yep. Yeah, that's good.
I think that's there. It's
more accurate.
Move that the CPDC approve the minutes for the meeting of August 14th, 2017, as amended.
Second.
All in favor? Okay. All right, so 8 o'clock we had the request. We're supposed to do the continued public hearing for the site plan review at 292 Grove Street, Meadowbrook Golf Club, but the applicant has requested a continuance to October 16th. Who's not here for that? Brooke, no.
Okay. Move that the CPDC continue the public hearing for the site plan review and special permit at Meadowbrook Golf Club until Monday, October 16th.
7:30.
At 7:30.
Second.
All in favor? I thought that was just a notice. I didn't know we had a vote on that.
Say it again?
I don't think we voted on the continuances before. We just announced them. But
fine.
Okay. So all we have left is minutes. Are you here for something specific? Just to enjoy the
observation.
Oh, great.
I will say I'm having a real difficult time hearing anybody.
I know, this room is horrible, and we've spoken about it.
Well, you guys are also really quiet. I have trouble hearing them, and they're like arm's length from me.
I usually sit back there, and I came as close as I dared to.
No, these walls are not good for acoustics.
No, I mean, that's true, but you are really cool.
I'm telling you, Grafton has an incredible, I think it's Grafton. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what you said.
Incredible. You can hear a pin drop all the way down across the room. No HVAC noise, no lights buzzing. Okay, minutes for August
28th.
August 28th.
Yeah, the next to last paragraph. I don't remember what I actually said, but what I was attempting to ask about was the potential for the signalized crosswalk from Minot Street across Main Street. This is, I mean, what's here is also true, but I think the Pizza World connection was further down on Main Street.
Yeah, it would be. Okay.
With yeah, that's right. 136 Hayes.
No, they came on the 11th as well.
Okay.
The paragraph one up from the one we just talked about. The last sentence. I don't know exactly what I said, I think the intent was that the town, we could do something without hiring a consultant. That makes it sound like I was trying to direct town
so
staff to do
like
something.
So maybe like Mr. Weston clarified that he thinks town staff could begin addressing the parking situation without hiring a consultant.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Town staff or the
town? But the town.
That
doesn't necessarily need to be
town,
town staff.
Town.
Yeah.
Like without hiring a consultant, what would that mean? It would be
committees.
Town staff.
Well, it could be
committees.
Yeah.
You
want to volunteer for it.
I feel like you guys are already like so overcommitted. Okay.
It's a huge planning and development issue.
Yeah, yes. We need to, I guess, encourage some more focus on it. Yeah.
Right, but it's not just our issue. It's,
right.
You know, that would need to be one that also involves the select.
See, if that's what you meant to say, that's not at all how I heard what you were saying. I thought you were like, you need to fix this problem.
No, that's not.
It's like, okay.
No, I mean, as some of the public have said.
Sorry if that's the way.
It's okay.
It might have been the time of night, too.
Yeah.
We have several substantial projects.
I know.
You know, that are either in or immediately around the downtown area. And between the post office and the 40B across the tracks and the fire repair and the one by St. Agnes. I mean,
Yes.
There's a fair amount of stuff going on, so we got to make sure that we don't lose something, lose some opportunity.
In getting input from Andrew.
Yeah.
On what
he is
what
like,
they need, what is needed,
right.
And he's probably the closest to it.
He's working on it, like right now. So we had a meeting with some of the business owners last week to get some feedback and some suggestions about what should be done. Or so, and really can agree. And it's hard to
right.
know, like, until you implement something, like how it's going to really work.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then you've probably seen the email about the Economic Development Summit on October 4th. We're on that invite list, I hope. Anybody?
Does not ring a bell.
Okay, well, I did give Andrew your emails for that.
Did it come from Andrew?
Yeah.
I definitely didn't see it.
Yeah, I didn't see anything.
Okay. All right, well, that's next week, so.
I mean, I know which ones of yours I ignored, but I didn't see any from him.
All right, well, I will have that forwarded to you, but it's happening next Wednesday at the library. And Jay Ash is coming.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So.
Okay.
It's not a small thing.
Move that the CPDC approve the minutes for the meeting of August 28th, 2017 as amended.
Second.
All in favor? Anything else?
I was going to remind you of a couple of things. So next Monday, just a reminder, you have another CPDC meeting next Monday. I'm sure you remember that. And a site visit to 26 Green Street, which is an abutting property to 24 Gold Street. If you can make it, the neighbor would like you to view the potential visual impact from her porch. So I scheduled that at 7. And we'll meet there. And then Wednesday is the Economic Development Summit, which I'll send you the invite tomorrow. And then there's the Housing Production Plan Renewal Community Forum on October 30th, which is a Monday that you don't have a meeting. And it would be great if you guys could help facilitate that. The housing consultant has asked me to find people to help facilitate. So I saw your email and I appreciate that. If you're able to attend.
I don't know that I'll be back in time.
Okay.
It's the 30th, you said.
Yeah.
Okay.
And there will be some official invitations going out for that as well. So it's a little bit more of a limited scope this time, this update, because in 5 years when we have to update it again, we'll have new census data. And so we'll do a much bigger overhaul at that time. This is just kind of a limited renewal to keep us certified.
Okay.
Speaking of certification, we have a 2-year safe harbor as of, I guess, Friday.
Ah.
I applied for that when the post office got approved. Put you over the 1% in 1 year. So, yeah. DHCD has approved that.
Okay. Make sure we use that to our advantage.
We are always strategizing behind the scenes. Well, thank you for that, so. Yeah.
Anything else?
How are we in membership? I mean, ours?
Nothing that I know of, but I'm usually the last about that kind of stuff.
Okay.
So, I don't think we've had any papers submitted for any members.
Okay.
So. But we're almost like over the busy hump, so you guys did it.
It'd still be good to have a fifth
one. It would definitely be good, yes.
Okay.
Move to adjourn.
Second. In
favor? 47 minutes.